dramatic. That Jesus is sandwiched between two thieves. One is ridiculing him and saying, if you're really the Son of God, why don't you come down and rescue us? Akala ba namin eh magaling ka? And the other one defends Jesus and says, hindi ka ba natatakot? Hindi ka ba kinikilabutan? Tayo, kaya tayo nakabitin sa Christ na to dahil nagkasala tayo. Tama lang makarusaan tayo. Yung tao to, ginawa niya masama. And he looks at Jesus and says, would you please remember me when you are in paradise? Parang sinasabi niya na, alam ko, ikaw mabuting tao, papasok ka sa kaharian ng Diyos. Ako hindi. Sapat na sa akin, tandaan mo lang ako pag nakapasok ka. And Jesus says, Aiden, I say to you today, pagkasabi mo niya, you are already with me. That's how merciful the Lord is. Even at the very last moment. Ito, narinig natin, the Canaanite woman. How great is your faith, woman? Yung mga babaeng ito, what is she? An Israelite? No, she's a pagan. Kaya nga siya tinataboy ng mga apostol. Anong karapatan mo? Bakit ka humihiling na mapagaling ka eh? Di, hindi ka ba't sumasampalataya sa Diyos na rin? Umayos ka nga dyan. At sinubong siya kay Jesus. At si Jesus, sinubungan pa siya, sinabi niya, you know what? I have come only for the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Wow! Malanggol pa. Pagkatapos eh, nagkulit ang babae, please sir, help me. Ang sabi niya, hindi naman niya tatama na kumuha ng pagkain sa mesa ng amo at itapon sa mga aso. Nagalit ba yung babae? Hindi. Nakakainsulto ang sinabi ni Jesus, ha? Sa isang prayer of imagination, kinonfront ko si Jesus doon. Masyado ko naman, Jesus, ha? Yung tama yun, insulto mo yung babae. Now you see, he said very insulting word. But the woman did not react. She remained humble. Anong sinabi niya? Kung tatagalugin natin ganito, sir, hindi po ako humihingi ng kapatid. Alam ko po, wala akong kapatid. Ang hinihiling ko po, humula. In case na po, tapos yun ang magagod lahat ng mga Hudyo. Kung may natitira pa kayong awa sa anak ko, kahit hindi mo ko parinihin, sir. And Jesus said, how great is your faith? I don't know what faith Jesus was talking about. This woman was not a believer in Yahweh. She's a Canaanite, she's a pagan. I think what Jesus meant was, how great is your love? How great is that love that is ready to accept ridicule for the sake of the God? The foundation of faith is love. To the poor, Jesus said, how blessed are you, the kingdom of God is yours. To the weary, he said, I will give you rest. These are all words of mercy. Jesus presented the face of Jesus is the mercy of the Father, the mercy of God. Jesus gives a face to the mercy of the Father. For Jesus to proclaim the gospel is to bring about an encounter with God through experiences of God's mercy, healing, peace, power, presence. Those in need of God's mercy are the poor. And he borrowed this from Isaiah 61. Jesus proclaimed the poor as the primary beneficiaries of the gospel. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor. Hindi niya sinabi, he has sent me to bring good news, period. The good news is specifically for those who acknowledge their poverty. It's for the poor. God's kingdom is for the poor. Blessed are you poor, he says, kingdom of God is yours. Luke 6. I ask myself, did Jesus mean it? Not only did he seem to mean it, he rubbed it in. Look what he said. How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Kaya yung reaksyon ng mga alagad, shock. They were scandalized. And their question is, sino po maliligtas kung gano'n? Who can be saved? Kaya na Matthew is offensive. Buti na lang si Matthew, no? Pinalabot niya. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Kaya meron tayong vocabulary ng spiritual poverty. Poor in spirit. But most Bible scholars believe that the original formulation is really blessed are you poor. Is, hey look, the kingdom of God is yours. And he actually meant the poor. But then of course, we have developed a positive notion of poverty. Poverty in spirit. Or a spiritual poverty. Biblical tradition does not glorify poverty. It does not romanticize or justify or idealize poverty. It is clear both about the positive and the negative, the pejorative, the positive and the pejorative meanings of poverty. Mayroong positive meaning at may negative meaning. A distinction is made between poverty as a value and poverty as a disvalue. Poverty can lead to either a breakdown or a breakthrough. It can lead to a breakdown in the sense of dehumanization. I'm sure you have met poor people who are degraded by their poverty, dehumanizing poverty, criminality, breakdown of law and order. Kapag dahil sa gutom, ang tao ay natututong maghonda, magnakaw, breakdown of morality and dignity. Doon sa amin, natuklasan ko, doon sa isang dugaw sa kalsada, may ibang mga babae, kahit daw sa latang sardinas lang, they were willing to prostitute themselves. Meron palang prostitution for the poor. Yung mga trappers, ginagawa sa mga tabilang ng kalye, sa mga nakaparadang jeep, paggabi. Yun, 50 pesos lang. On the other hand, poverty can lead to a breakthrough. A breakthrough of mercy, care, solidarity, tenderness, compassion, upliftment of dignity. Meron kami isang kabataan, ang pangalan si Paulo. He was born in prison. Ang nanay niya was in jail for estafa. In Angeles District Jail. Ngayon, buntis siya during that time. Kaya isinilang ang bata sa pulungan. At kukunin na sana ng DSWD yung bata na makaawa yung nanay to nurse the child. To be allowed to at least pasusuhin yung anak niya. Eh, nagdaan ang mga buwan. Nung bumalik ang DSWD, tinago na yung bata ng mga prisoners mismo. Napamahal yung bata doon sa mga prisoners. Kaya lumaki yung bata in prison. Nag-aaral siya sa labas, umuwi sa jail. Border. In the meantime, na-convict ang nanay niya, na-transfer siya sa prison correctional. Hindi pwede isama yung bata. Inalagaan ng mga prisoners. Nag-chip in sila, they put up a Paulo fund para mapaaral si Paulo. Dumaan ang panahon, natapos ng elementary si Paulo, natapos ng high school, at nakakuha ng scholarship sa Holy Angel University at nag-volunteer sa Holy Rosary Parish. Kasama namin siya sa prison apostolate. Dahil taga doon siya. Taga doon. Alam niyo, nakakalusaw ng puso pag pumasok si Paulo sa prison. Ang lahat ng mga prisoners, mga nanay at tatay niya. You would think that, you know, itong prisoners, they help Paulo. Hindi baliktad, Paulo helped the prisoners. Because his presence in jail drew from the prisoners mercy and compassion. Tumaas ang pagkatao niya. Mula nung pumasok si Paul sa loob ng district jail, nawala ang mga gangs. Nag-behave sila kasi may bata. Amazing. By the way, si Paul pag-graduate lang niya ng education. At natanggap siya ngayon, teacher sa Holy Angel University. Kasama pa rin namin sa Holy Rosary College. Volunteer sa aming office. Umuwi pa rin sa district jail. Hindi niya maiwan ang mga tito-tita niya, mga nanay at tatay niya. At malapit nang lumaya sa koreksyonal ang nanay niya. At naghahanda na siya ng matitirahan nila. He wants to rebuild his family. You see, in the midst of poverty, there can be a breakthrough of mercy and compassion. So poverty in the positive sense refers to a value of detachment, simplicity, trust in providence, the value of solidarity, mercy, and compassion, the value of humility and admission that we are all poor in the sight of God. Sino hindi nangangailangan ng awa ng Diyos? God's example of poverty is Christ's kenosis, God's self-emptying act in the passion and death of Christ. Sabi ito ni St. Paul, "For you know the generous act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though He was rich, yet for your sakes He became poor, so that by His poverty you might become rich." It's now the positive poverty is the poverty that enriches, the poverty that uplifts, the poverty that builds solidarity, the poverty that draws mercy. So we would understand why the poor are the privileged addressees of the good news. Unfortunately, good news is bad news for those who are not disposed for it. They're not poor. And our example for that is the rich young man in the gospel. He went away sad, for he had many possessions. Very ironic ito. Umalis siyang malungkot dahil saksakan siya ng yaman. Di ba dapat umalis siyang masaya kasi marami siyang pera, mayaman siya. But because he has met Jesus, after not being able to take Jesus' challenge, he went away sad. You know, this is being presented positively by the gospel writer. He went away sad. It's good that he went away sad. That is the beginning of evangelization. To be sad that you have not, that you do not yet have the courage to go for the real treasures in life. To be sad because you realize that this is not the real treasure that you have. Kaya si Mark, dinagdag niya dito yung Jesus looked at him with love. Ano ibig sabihin? Siguro sinabi ni Jesus, babalik ka rin. least very good. You are sad. You realize it, that you are in need of the real treasure of life. Oh, I'm sorry I ate up the time. I probably don't have time anymore for Francis. Let me just jump now to the conclusion. Let me jump a little more. Okay. So, Francis himself, I was going to present to you his own story of awakening to God's love, to the sweet sound of God's voice and God's amazing dreams. Because he was himself the rich young man who realized how empty his life was, how poor. And so he went out to seek the real world and discovered it in Jesus. This is what the joy of the gospel is about. Marami tayong kinakaharap ng mga tao who are poor, who are empty, who are longing for treasure. People who are hungry, who are longing for God's food. The joy of the gospel is about the joy that amazes. Alam niyo yung Amazing Grace, di ba? The song Amazing Grace. Ang sabi niya, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Dati akala ko dapat, I once was lost, but now I found. Active. Pero passive voice pala siya. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Meaning, I did not find him, he found me. That is the good news. The good news is, nahanap niya ako. I'm found. Like a lost sheep whom the shepherd did not give up on. Alam niyo yung, may isang painting ang ganda-ganda, no? Isang nakabitin na tupa sa gilid ng bangin. Pagkatapos, ang pastol ay nakahawak sa isang puno. Tapos, inaabot niya yung nahulog niyang tupa na nasa gilid ng bangin. Ini-imagine ko yun, binibigyan ko ng dialogue. Yung parang, yung tupa, ikaw. Let's say, tayo yung tupa. Nahulog ka sa bangin dahil sa yung kataragaduhan, kabulastugan, kabangmangan, katangatan. And it happens. And then just when you think God has given up on you, parang bigla mo siyang narinig. Nagsabi, ayun ka lang pala. Wala kang magawa kundi mag-iiyak dun sa sulok. Probably blaming yourself. Only to discover that hindi pala natulog ang pastor. Hinawag ka niya. He never gave up on you. And when he found you, he took you and put you on his shoulders. And he was leaping and jumping with joy. That's the joy of the gospel. I was lost, but I have been found. It's not because of me, it's because of him. It is his choice. Ito yung the revolution of Jesus. It was not easy for the Pharisees, for the Jewish people to accept. The vocabulary of forgiveness. Just when you thought he had left you to die in the dark, cold, the cold dark night, it was after all your fault that you had gotten lost. You suddenly hear his voice calling, and you realize he has not forgotten. He never stopped looking for you. You were blind, but now you see. You see what? You see the shepherd's joy in finding you and bringing you home. Kaya doon sa painting na isa pa, yung sheep, yung lamb, ay nasa balita, ng pastor. Tapos, yung pastor, sumisigaw sa tuwa, nakatingin doon sa pinupuntahan niya, pero yung tupa, nakatingin sa mata ng pastor. The joy of the shepherd. Siguro, let's end with a sing-along. To feel the joy of the gospel. Kasi, amazing grace, you know. This is about God's amazing, the joy of the gospel is about God's amazing grace. The amazing grace of the God who never gives up on anyone. And who expects us to act in His person, to sacramentalize the mercy and compassion.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.